I was having a random thought, guys. Very random this morning. I woke up and then I was thinking about shit to play today. And then I just had a random thought back to how good music in 07 was. I woke up this morning, I said, wow, man. It's so much shit that came out that year.
Do you love me?
That we just, maybe I need to brush y'all up on it.
Is this really your real
It was a really great year of music. Oh boy, Atlanta and everywhere far and wide. If you in your car, if you at work, turn this shit up, turn it up, turn it up. Episode 66, Rich Boy. Niggas wanna take shit tight, no stick, just bought a cat. I gotta let this one ride, Saadia, sorry.
Just bought a cat. I don't know if this is in my head, I was like, this is a great pick.
Boy, today would have had a fit in here.
Yeah, he probably would have liked this one. He would be like, fuck.
Throw some D's on that bitch. Just bought a
Cadillac. What is 07, 07? How old were we? About 12?
I can't get my age up.
He said, I can't get my age.
You're too old now.
We had to be about 13. We thought we knew everything. We thought we knew the world. We ain't no shit.
I did.
But where were you when this came out?
Oh yeah, this is a classic.
And you thought this was T-Pain. Well, at least I thought it was T-Pain at first.
Yeah, I knew it was Snoop.
Yo, am I like the only person? I heard this shit and I was like, oh, okay, this is a good T-Pain song. So nigga was like, bro, this Snoop. I said, wait, Snoop Doggy Dog?
This one's out of his character though, but this one, ooh, this was a good one.
And I didn't believe it until I saw the video. Then I looked at the video a few times while he performed it and I said, okay, all right, that's Snoop.
Okay, wait, real quick.
I'm gonna take my time.
Did you like sensual seduction better or
sensual seduction?
I like sensual seduction
I'm not doing sexual eruption. That's one of the rare cases where the clean version is just way harder than the dirty version. You can't go with this shit. I think I'ma just play random 07 songs all episode. Just so y'all niggas know, like, some good shit happened that year.
She might be with him, but she's thinking about me.
She's always thinking about me, even when she with him. Ain't that some shit? It's like that little Fizz thing. Yeah, we gotta get into that, man. That's, oh boy. And to end out this intro, oh man.
Yo, this is Nappy Boy Radio Live with your boy T-Pain. We love
I'm gonna play some shit all episode.
Nah, I do. I used to like this song. We got a
caller. You ain't really like it like that.
What's your problem? I was younger.
Now that I'm older, this shit go harder. Oh no, I listen to music as music. Like I'm listening to mixes, I'm listening to how he where he was in his career then. I just be listening to shit different. Oh no. That shit gets harder today. Oh no. Chris Brown come in. Like the way he just came in, I'm like, okay. When I heard this shit, I said Chris Brown had arrived. I'ma make it up, Saadia. I'ma make it up.
We always will miss it.
Except for this time. This one time out of like 500 songs. But I intro this shit, man. Welcome to the What's in My Bag podcast. It is me, your host, Louis B. I'm joined by some friends, none other than Saadia. Speak to him, my gal.
What's up?
Jide couldn't be here today, nigga. Talking about he getting to the bag. So I said, alright, nigga, do your thing. But late in the fourth, I can always call on my brother. You can always call on your brothers in battle. JP, talk to him, my guy.
JP, what up, world?
Oh man, what is going on, everybody? How y'all feeling, man? We're gonna have a great pod today. I sense great things happening. How you feeling, man? What's going on?
Well, for one, your spot really not in too deep of the country. When I made my way out here, y'all made it seem like it was just cow pastures everywhere. Just
you did run nah, past you, some you getting some, here, didn't you?
But man, once you get to your spot, it lives up a little bit.
It looks suburban, but I mean, it is real far from Atlanta. I don't know, that commute, that got to be crazy.
It's nasty. But yes, man, I'm so glad. Okay, for y'all know Josh ain't been on this damn podcast since like episode
50.
Yeah,
I was
here. Something like that. Shit, it's been a long time. So I'm glad to have him back. He hasn't even been over here like to see the place since I've moved. So I'm glad he's finally here. I'm finally glad he made this drive out to the country. See, he was one of the, I think it's always good to show gratitude to people. Thank you for coming. Saadia, thank you for always being here. Because y'all niggas really do come out here, and it's a stretch. I do understand that. And nobody has complained, and I'm so thankful. I know y'all want to.
Hey, it's but, a grind, man. You got to start somewhere. So
Yeah. My next move will definitely be closer to the city, because everything used to literally be, oh yeah, bro, I'd be there in about 15 minutes. Everywhere that I was, I could get anywhere in 15 minutes. Now it's about 40 everywhere, and it's
disgusting. At the very minimum 40.
Huh?
At a very minimum 40.
Maybe about 47, 50. But yeah, man, let me look at my list. What's going on? Anybody do anything special for Halloween? Anything spooky?
What do we do? I know I went to the Hawks game. They had, like, just regular stuff.
Did Trey get hurt on Halloween?
No, he got hurt the game before.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, but apparently he's supposed to be back, like, in a week, so.
We'll a see. Week?
Yeah, possibly at the earliest.
What injury? Oh, okay, I'm thinking about Steph. Never mind.
Yeah, Steph.
Yeah, the war.
Boy's gone.
Are we still fans?
I'm a Hawks fan. I want to let that be known. I only fuck with the Hawks.
Yeah. Getting them Peachtree jerseys as soon as they drop. Saadia, what did you do for Halloween?
I went to 1145 with my friends.
Oh, that's the lounge, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't been there in a minute. How was that?
It was super, super packed. Literally, we first walked in, like, everybody was pushing everybody, you know, people acting like they was finna fight, you know, you literally just had to, like, get out the way. And it was to the point where, like, the crowd was pushing you. I've never been in a setting where I'm like, oh, shit, I'm being separated from my friends. And, like, literally, it was to the point where, like, I had to go over by one of my friends. They pushed us to the side. And then once I found my other friend, like, I just grabbed her arm like a mom, just snatched her to me, because I'm like... They just swinging us everywhere at this point.
So you was just having a normal Atlanta night on Halloween. Sounds about
but
normal.
After that, you know, once people kind of like lit up, because Lil Key was supposed to be performing. So
that's why I was so bad.
Yeah, it was.
Okay.
I've never seen it.
We gotta go see
ever.
Lil Key. Bye. You know what I'm saying? Gotta go see Lil Key. Yeah. What songs does he have? He have anything like popular? Because I don't. You know, I'm out of tune.
I forgot. He got some songs.
Did you record the record?
Huh?
Did you record that?
No.
You sound whatever it is. You sound like it.
I'll do good impressions.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
What are some of your best impressions?
I'm not gonna tell you.
Bernie Mac.
No, I can't do that now.
I swear, for Lord, them goddamn kids. No,
that is good.
That was straight.
I can do some, like, singers, and maybe, like, people. If I'm around you long enough and I, like, study you, I can probably mimic you.
Get your tendencies.
Yeah. How was my Halloween? What did I do? I attended, my church does an annual, like, trunk or treat type thing, but it was raining, so it was brought indoors. So we basically just had, like, a Halloween thing at the church. To keep these kids out the streets.
Was you Batman again?
No, I was, and let's get the drums ready, guys. I was an Oscar.
Classic.
Like, I'm gonna show it to you. I'm gonna show it to you.
Okay.
And yeah, this is because it's out the way now, and I don't really, I don't care. It's done. Damn it, where is it? I'll show it to you guys.
Man, Oscar. Yeah. Talking about the Grinch.
I mean,
no,
like the trophy I had on a bodysuit.
You did a good job.
I meant
job.
The grouch.
I had on a bodysuit.
Yo, he did a good job.
He was an Oscar. Hey, bro, why you didn't post that,
cool,
right?
Yeah.
I'm cool on that, man.
You
cool.
Gotta post that shit now.
See, I'm like a lot of people, I don't really care about doing shit for the limelight. I'm just gonna do it for the kids, man.
So you stood in the same spot all night?
I stood on that damn, what was that? That was a speaker. I stood on that speaker for 3 hours straight. My legs were fucking
jelly. So wait,
jelly.
When the kids walked by, you didn't like try to jump at them or nothing?
Nah, I think in hindsight, I think I was a pretty bad statue. I was just like moving and shit, bro. I was like, my head moving and shit. Like when somebody performing, I'm moving. Like I was a bad statue, but the kids enjoyed it. They're young, they're impressionable. They don't know what the fuck is going on. Half of them are scared, so... It was fun. I always like giving back to the kids.
Had the gold bodysuit on. That's funny.
Oh, what? Stupid ass commercials?
No, I'm talking about you.
Oh, I did have. And actually, my bodysuit broke. Like, the damn back, the zipper broke. So, I had a wardrobe malfunction. It was bad. But one of the guys was able to, like, tape me up and shit. So, I was good. It was a church event, so I had to make sure, like, I kept my dick covered because my dick was fully exposed. I came down, and one of my homegirls from the church, she was like, make sure you wear some drawers next time you wear a bodysuit. I said, I was wearing drawers. What you talking about? So I was over there overhearing somebody. They was like, oh, who is that over there with the gold ding-a-ling? I said, oh, God, not here.
It was kind of showing, though, on the side. Even but in the picture, it was like trying to
I gotta look at it
side.
Again. Cause it was, like, stop looking at my dick, Saadia. I'm just kidding.
Yes, I'm not gonna look at
episode 66.
Anymore. I'm sorry.
Just kidding.
Don't blame me. You don't want to award. And then you didn't even put the bat in the middle. You supposed to put it in the middle. Like you.
I did. It was in the middle. But I guess it just slid around. And yeah, I was exposed. So, yeah. Since October 31st is over and November 1st was, what's today, the 2nd? So it was yesterday. Mm-hmm. I feel that it is completely time now to celebrate the one and only greatest holiday of all time. Shouts out to the queen that's gonna forever eat off this shit every fucking year as soon as Christmas comes. She's never not gonna eat, and that's crazy. I wish I could make a fucking Christmas album. Oh my God.
And she has the best voice for
Christmas.
R&B, but like.
I thought Chris Brown did a
good. Oh, you talking about This Christmas?
That's
another classic.
Yeah, that was
another
good. That was good.
But he don't have a Christmas album.
No.
I think he can make some money. Like, I think he can make money, like, not on her level, but up there.
He
like,
probably
if he
could.
Made a Christmas
he should.
Album.
He, instead of just giving us a bonus version that's supposed to be Christmas of his 45 song album. Mm-hmm.
Don't do that
anymore.
Like, I think people would listen to the Chris Brown Christmas album.
They would definitely listen to that, but the Chris don't do that 45.
That's too much.
15.
Attention span.
I don't even know 45 separate Christmas songs. I'm done after like the top 10 that everybody should know. So yes, I just really thought about how Mariah is going.
Alexander O'Neal.
Huh?
My gift to you. That's my number one. I don't celebrate Christmas. I care less about Christmas. But
what?
I enjoy every year when they play the Christmas songs just so I can hear that song. I love My Gift to You by Alexander O'Neal.
So do you even like the whole spirit of Christmas?
You know, Muslims, I mean, it's like... But I do enjoy the family.
Yeah.
That part, undeniable.
Yeah. So yes, we'll get back into Christmas when we get closer to it. I just felt like as soon as November 1st comes, it's definitely Christmas mode. Watch all of these stores. They are going to capitalize off this. I'm sure the wreaths are already up. The trees are already being prepared.
Oh yeah,
and
I walked
shipped.
In Walmart. It's stuff already up.
Santas are everywhere, and it is time. Oh man, sad news, man. John Witherspoon pops.
Mm.
Pops.
Yeah.
Pops.
R.I.P. Wasn't they making a new Friday?
They was talking about making a new Friday. Boondocks was coming back.
Yeah.
He still had movies in the works from what I was reading. He still had roles to do. So, I mean, yeah. And if you have been living under a rock for the past week, John Witherspoon was pronounced dead earlier this week. He died at the age of 77.
Mm-hmm.
He lived a good life. Mm. He lived a good life. He impacted the lives of a lot of people. Definitely gave me some good laughs. Friday.
For sure.
Put some water on that shit. That is real. Because you got to put some water on that shit sometimes. Mm. It gets rough. You got to do what you got to do. And he was the nigga to speak up on that. So, Pops, rest in paradise, man. Y'all got anything y'all want to add to that? No?
You sounded up, man.
Let me see if I can get some happy music to change course. Is there anything else sad that's going on? I feel like L.A. is still on fire. I feel like L.A. is still on fire. I feel like, what happened? Chicago is snowing. Detroit's snowing already. Jeez. I woke up this morning and saw a little frost on my thing. Actually, I'm not going to put
no happy
music. It's okay.
It's crazy how the weather
snow is coming soon.
It's crazy how the weather changes at the same time every year. Like, it seems right on Halloween is when it get cold. It's like, it'll be 90 degrees the week before, and every time, like, Halloween hit, it just gets 40 to 50 degrees. It's crazy.
But see, I feel like last year, Halloween was hot, and we actually got the cold this year. I guess, I don't know what happened, but literally, I remember the day. Like, the weather changed midday.
Mm-hmm.
It was warm when I went outside, and then by the end of the day, it was cold as shit, so... I don't know what's going on with this weather, man, but God, just be with us. And when you're ready, just give us a little hint. Give us a little hint so that we can be prepared. And
see, the rain comes, shoot. My dad told me, like, it's going to be a cold front when it rained.
Mm.
It came that night.
Mm. Your dad should have been a meteorologist. Your dad is a great man.
My dad is the best man.
Talk about that a little bit, because you always talk about your dad. Very highly. You regard him highly.
He is.
I don't hear that. I guess I just asked you to expound upon that, because we really don't hear that a lot in the Black community. I know it sounds cliche, but in all realness, like, until Father's Day, until Mother's Day, niggas ain't talking about their parents like that. Niggas ain't, oh man, I really love them at the end of the day. I really do. Niggas ain't saying that. And I really admire the way that you talk about your dad, because, yeah, that's all I'll say is yeah.
No, I'm a daddy's girl till I die, though, so.
See, that, I think, like, once I get a daughter and everything, I'm probably going to favor my daughter. Like, a couple.
Fuck you, son.
A couple years ago, you asked me this, like, I would have never been like, oh, I don't want no daughters or nothing like that. But, like, if I come to the terms, like, if, like, girls running my family, so I'm probably going to have.
A couple
daughters. Ooh. So, you know, that being said, it's like, now that I think about it, like, she gonna be a daddy girl, because she probably gonna get everything, like, if she wanna ask for it. So
I don't know if I'm ready for a daughter just yet.
Ooh. I don't want no kids no time soon.
You'd be a great dad. I think
I'd be a great dad, but daughters, ooh, I don't know. It's like, as soon as they come out, it's.
See, I'm be lenient with my son, man. They get away. Like, it ain't really gonna be too much. Like,
and really, I want to have.